Friends, welcome to Center for Online Education. In the series of production management, today we are going to discuss another important topic that is known as work system design. Work system design, as you all know, that for any activity to be performed in a production system, you require certain work. And this work is going to be dependent on the two factors that is known as the humanitarian factor or behavior factor and the technical factor, which is being in the qualitative or quantitative terms. Now let's explore that is what is work system design. Work design. So work design is the application of socio-technical system, principles and techniques to the humanitization of work. Means all the activity in a production system is being done by the people. Automation has helped the people in most of the work to be done in a proper time. But humanitarian ground is very important. So here, by the help of work system design, we use to inflow the activity, keeping in mind the skill which a person or the worker possesses. The aim of the work design are to improve job satisfaction, to improve throughput, to improve quality, and to reduce employee problems. Means the overall structure of a work system design is all about the job satisfaction. How much we are going to design our system so that the person who is performing that specific job is going to be satisfied by his job. The overall output is best. And apart from that, the problems which an employee used to face is going to be reduced, or he or she hasn't have any problem in performing his specific work. Job design. Job design is concerned with structuring job in order to improve organizational efficiency and employee job satisfaction. Now, whenever we are going to talk about the work, as you all know that a work is being differently divided into different jobs. So here, job design is very important. Why? What a person is going to do and what are the capabilities which he or she should possess to complete that specific task. So all these things are being defined in job satisfaction and in job design. The design of the job should reflect both technological and human consideration. Again, both the factors should be taken into account, and there must be a balance between the behavior system, that is all the social consideration which an employee, which a worker needs to carry his work. Apart from that, all the technical help which he should have. He should have a proper knowledge, a skill, and technological awareness for completion of his own work. It should facilitate the achievement of organizational objective. Facilitate the organizational effectiveness is very important while he is carrying the task, because overall each and every job is going to fulfill the organizational objectives, and this objectives when completed is going to make an organization more and more effective. So for an organization to be effective, you must have a proper job system that is being divided by the help of the job objectives. Now, internal job motivation. There are certain motivational factors which used to help an individual while carrying his activity. So there are the three factors which is being discussed over here. The first is the person must experience responsibility for the result of the work. Means all the activity is being performed by a specific person and he, she should be responsible for his own work. Whatever task he is carrying should have a proper accountability and responsibility relation over there. Means if a worker used to be responsible, if he feels that he is responsible for his activity, he is going to carry or perform his task in an efficient manner. Second thing, the person must have knowledge of the result of his work or her work. Means whatever task he is performing, he should know that what are the skills he is being required. How he is going to perform that task. Proper knowledge of the activity must be there before carrying the task. So this results the proper efficiency of a person. Then the third one, the person must experience the work as meaningful. Means all the person who is performing a task must feel that whatever task they are performing has a meaningful output. And if they feel that it is a meaningful output, automatically overall task
is being done in a very proper and an easy manner. Now, job design. So what is job design? A job design can be defined as a set of tasks and responsibilities of a worker. Means, what are the responsibilities which a worker carries while performing his job and how he is going to carry his job. It should be divided into proper pointing system, and he should be known that this is the task and this is the responsibility which he has to perform. So when we used to frame this, we say that this is a system of job design. We have designed the job, and according to that, a worker has to perform his work. Now, job design has got two parts, that is known as job description and job specification. By the name itself says that job description is all what tells about the job. How the job is going to be done, what is going to be done in the job, where the job is going to be done, means everything is being described in a proper manner. What are the qualifications which is being required? So here job, what is the salary which a person is going to earn? Everything is being given in the job description. But when we talk about job specification, here all the skills which is being required, how the work is going to be completed, it should be given into proper. So job description tells about the job, and job specification tells that how the job is going to be done. So these two are the parts of the job design. Techniques of job design. There are four techniques of the job design. The first one is job simplification. Second one is job enlargement. Third one is job rotation. And fourth one is the job enrichment. By the name itself says that it is all deal with the job. Job is the task and the responsibility which a person has to perform in his work. So here, the first point is job simplification. As simplification means that we have to divide or we have to give the job into different parts so that all the activity will be simplified in the most lenient manner. So here, when a person says that his job is being simplified, that all the activity is properly defined, it should be known by a person, he should be given a proper knowledge so that he can perform that activity. So job simplification is making the job easier for a worker so that he can carry all the tasks in a very simplified manner. Now job enlargement. Enlargement means says that is bigger than the responsibility which is carrying. So sometimes you see that there is an attrition of a worker or there is a turnover of the worker in the organization. So sometimes additional job process is being added in the working culture of a person, of a people. For example, a person has to follow a multiple job responsibilities. So when a person is being levied by extra charges in his department, it is being said that his job is being enlarged. Means apart from doing his own work activity and carrying all his responsibilities and tasks which he is being assigned, he is also carrying the work of another person who is not there, or he is being given some additional charges of an organization. So when this happens, we say that there is a job enlargement. Then the third one is job rotation. In the modern organization, we used to require a skilled worker, a worker who is trained, who knows all the activities of the organization, because God knows that at what time, what activity he has to perform. So job rotation helps an individual, an employee, to get the knowledge of different jobs from time to time. So here, we used to rotate the individual employee into different departments or in the same department at different places so that he has got the primary knowledge of all the activity or the task which is being performed by his own department. So job rotation helps an individual to have a knowledge and skills about the different jobs, and it helps the increasing of efficiency of an individual. Then you have got job enrichment. This is the fourth process. Job enrichment says that here a person used to get the job which is being assigned bigger to the role which he has got the previously. Means sometimes a person has given an additional responsibility which is being upper to the present position which he is performing. For example, if a person is a cashier and he is being given a charge of accountant, so somewhere or the other, his job being enriched by the certain factors. Up till the work he is going to carry, he feels that his job being enriched. So somewhere or the other, sometimes the top management used to give additional input or the additional primary responsibilities of that specific job, which makes the job more easier or more fruitful or more motivational and satisfactional to the employee. We say that the job is being enriched. So somewhere or the other, techniques of the job design is being divided into four parts. The first is job simplification, where we are going to simplify the job. Second one is job enlargement, where we are going to give some additional responsibilities and enlarging the job of an individual person. Then job rotation means making a person to go into different jobs and getting the knowledge and skills about that specific jobs. And then we have got the fourth one, that is known as job enlargement, where we used to give additional responsibilities to a person. We used to increase the accountability of a person and makes the person feel more motivational and learn the more skill which is being required in the future. So these four parts are very important for a person to know about his job. Now, as you know, that work system is all about the behavior aspect and the technical aspect. So here, in this next part, we will say that what is the points which is going to be there. In the next part, I am going to explore you. But this is what the work system and job design is all about. I think you have understood. Thank you.